Simple hacks to boost your sleep naturally. Hello and welcome. I'm Dick Bain of Devon, Duvets, and today we are exploring the fascinating role of melatonin, your body's natural sleep hormone, and how you can use it to optimize your rest and wake up refreshed every day. But before we do this, don't forget to like, subscribe, so you're always notified of our latest content on sleep and well-being. And of course, I would love to hear from you. Let us know in the comments, what's your routine to wind down at night? Your tips could really help others improve their sleep. Now, let us start with a quick story from myself that may sound very familiar to you. I remember a few nights when I found myself up late working on emails or scrolling through my phone. And even though I was exhausted, I just couldn't seem to fall asleep afterwards. It turns out the reason was right in front of me. The light from my devices was interfering with my body's melatonin production. So, what is melatonin exactly? Melatonin is a hormone produced by the pineal gland in your brain, and it plays a key role in regulating your sleep-wake cycle. As the evening light fades, your brain starts producing more melatonin to prepare you for sleep. It is a signal that lets your body know it's time to wind down. Also important to know is that artificial light, especially the blue light from screens, can suppress melatonin production, making it harder for you to feel sleepy. Essentially, if your body isn't getting the right signals, your sleep can really suffer. Here are some very simple tips. Try to make your bedroom as dark as possible and start dimming the lights in your home about an hour before you go to bed. Even better, keep this routine consistent, as regularity helps your body's natural rhythms align with the day and night cycle, which in turn optimizes melatonin production. Just a quick question. Have you ever noticed how screen affects your sleep? Have you tried anything to reduce blue light exposure before bed? Feel free to drop a comment. I'm always curious to hear what works for others. Now, here's maybe a nice science fact to know that might surprise you. Did you know that certain foods can support melatonin production naturally? Foods like cherries, bananas, and almonds contain small amounts of melatonin, or nutrients that help the body make melatonin. So having a small, with emphasis on small, evening snack with one of these foods could actually contribute to better sleep. And speaking of natural methods, there's more to melatonin than just light and food. Relaxation plays a big part too. One way to naturally encourage melatonin production is to engage in relaxing activities before you go to bed, such as gentle yoga, stretching, or even breathing exercises and a good bedtime routine. Lowering your stress levels helps reduce cortisol, which is the body's stress hormone, and this makes it easier for melatonin to do its job. A breathing exercise can help. What you need to do is breathe in for 4 counts, hold for 4, and breathe out for 4. Doing this for a few minutes can work wonders to calm your mind and body. Now, you may be wondering, what about when the morning comes? How do we help our body shift from producing melatonin to feeling awake and energized? Here's some advice. Get some natural light exposure as soon as you wake up. Sunlight sends a powerful signal to your brain that it's time to reduce melatonin production and start producing wakeful hormones like cortisol. If you can, step outside for a few minutes, or at the very least, open your curtains wide to let in as much natural light as possible. Even on those gray days, outdoor light is much stronger than indoor light and can really help reset your internal clock. A tip I often share is to open curtains in the whole house as part of your morning routine. This lets in as much natural light as possible, signaling to your body that it's time to start the day. And if going outside isn't an option, turn on bright lights indoors. Can help your body recognize it's daytime. This is especially helpful if you are adjusting to a new schedule or trying to fix disrupted sleep patterns. By aligning your body with natural rhythms, waking up can become a bit easier and you'll feel more refreshed. So let us summarize what we have covered so far. Melatonin is your body's natural sleep aid, helping you wind down at night. And it works best when you are in sync with natural light and dark cycles. Dimming lights in the evening creates a calm environment, and allowing bright lights in the morning are a simple but powerful ways to support your body's natural rhythms. And before we end this podcast, I would love to hear from you. Do you have any evening rituals to help your body prepare for sleep? Or have you noticed that some things disrupt your melatonin production? Leave a comment to share your thoughts. You never know who might benefit from your experience. If you found this podcast helpful, be sure to like it and subscribe so you don't miss out on future insights on sleep and well-being, and help this channel further. If you are a person who often wakes up at 3 a.m., see my podcast, Waking Up at 3 a.m. Until next time, I'm Dick Bijen, wishing you a restful night and energized mornings. Here's to better sleep and a better life.